guys. Thanks for joining in tonight. It is a late, late Saturday night, and I'm doing exploitation film review, and you got it. Before there was ever Wild Eye releasing, we had the 1978 cult classic, Attack of the Killer Tomatoes. Let's give you a good look at this here. This is an NVD release. I'm sure most of you have this. This is a really nice release. And again, the film came out in 1978. I believe it was mass produced in 1977. Approximately 87 minutes long, directed and starring, oh no, the director was not actually in the film, but starring David Miller, George Wilson, Sharon Taylor, and Rock Peace. Directed by Joe DiBello and Steve Pence. Peace. And you do get a nice little poster with this film, if you get this particular release. Now, I'm not going to open it up, but just for nostalgic purposes. And I like to keep my stuff kind of together. I don't want to ruin it. So, let's revisit and talk about Attack of the Killer Tomatoes. So the premise of the film is you have this town and they are being overrun by killer tomatoes. Seems like a funny concept, but it's legit. The opening sequence has a woman who's doing dishes and there happens to be a tomato in the sink and it dispatches her. Legitimately, it kills the woman. Now, you don't see how they kill. You don't know how they kill. Other than the fact that, you know, she was killed by a killer tomato. So the police come, and they think that it's just a one-time incident, maybe an isolated incident. They don't think much of it. All of a sudden, throughout the world, people are being attacked and killed by tomatoes. And so now the government decides to get involved. The president decides to get involved. And it becomes very political, which has a lot to do with the premise of the film. But I won't get too much into that because if you've not seen it, you'll realize why that is the case in the film. So the premise of the film is people are trying to escape the tomatoes. The government's trying to fight back against the tomatoes. The military is involved. Special scientists are involved to try to figure out how to get rid of the tomatoes. There are secret characters and special characters that are being hired to dispatch the tomatoes as well. Trained assassins, if you will, to fight the tomatoes. Multiple characters, hysterical characters, to go up against the tomatoes. It was just multiple attempts, and it was just hysterical, absolute blast with the characters that they made for the film. So let me get to my thoughts on the film. This is a cult classic. People absolutely love this film, and there are people that absolutely hate this film. But like I said, this film was never made with any intention to be well recepted. It was ranked at one of the 25 worst movies of all time for a reason. But it backfired because it became legendary. As quoted by one of the actresses in the film, she went to a McDonald's As she was eating her French fries, Coke, and her hamburger, somebody walked up to her with a tomato, set it down in front of her, and said, "Sign this tomato." She signed the tomato, and also put Attack of Killer Tomatoes on the tomato. Johnny Carson mentioned Attack of the Killer Tomatoes. This film has a cult following, has three other sequels, Return of the Killer Tomatoes, Revenge of the Killer Tomatoes, and Killer Tomatoes Eats France with John Astin, who actually plays Dr. Gangrene in most of the sequels. Was absolutely hysterical. John Astin is perfect for those roles. But furthermore, this film has such a following. The budget was $80,000. Now, $60,000 of the budget was due to one of the most historic scenes in the film. And what some people believe to see was the scene that made the film take off and off the map was the helicopter crash. The helicopter crash actually was legit. It wasn't made to be like that. What happened was the tail caught the ground early, caused the crash to happen, and there was a fire. Luckily, the actor escaped. With that being said, because of those two incidents where the actors were almost killed, there's a lot of history in this film. Now, $60,000 of that budget went to that crash scene to pay for the rental helicopter that they crashed during the film. So I was extremely impressed with what they were able to do with $20,000 left on the budget. Now, to me, is it a great movie? Hell no. It's not made to be a great movie, though. It is a cult movie. And it has a huge following, and I had an absolute blast with it. In fact, I have an absolute blast with all of the films. Even the one with, you got it, George Clooney involved. So guys, I want to know, what is your thoughts on Attack of the Killer Tomatoes? Can you tell me your history on the film and your thoughts? Don't forget, tomorrow night, Monday, will be the first episode of the 80s Archive. And tonight, we'll be having the midnight hour at 10 o'clock for our live stream. Guys, thanks for sharing your time with me today and watching my review and thoughts on Attack of the Killer Tomatoes.